Hello everyone and welcome back to the walkthrough. This is 1-3. It was kind of an awkward leave-off last time, but what the heck. This is a hammer, brother. As you can tell, they throw hammers at you. Yay! They're also very awkward to get by. Luckily, they're not as broken in this game as they are in other Mario games. Other ones are just, like, nearly impossible to get by without taking a hit all the time. And this is Yoshi! Woo! You can jump on him and you'll be able to ride him, shake the Wii remote to jump off him. When you're up in the air and you hold the jump button, you'll do a little flutter jump like that. Eating 5 berries will give you a power-up. You can press the B button to lick in enemies, and that's all there is to Yoshi. He's very handy. He's also an extra hit for you, so you don't lose your power-up. Very nice. You can lap up shells. You can also lap up fireballs from, like, piranha plants and stuff like that. Even the piranha plants themselves will give Yoshi fireballs. So, you can shoot them at enemies in straight angles. Okay, that's really all there is about Yoshi now. So, let's just continue on the level here. Oh, no! Whoopsie! That was silly. Whenever you die in a level, you lose all the star coins that you collected, unless you hit a checkpoint, but even so, you have to complete the level. So let's not mess around this time and actually succeed. So let's grab our power-up and grab our Yoshi a little ahead, because we're going to actually need a Yoshi for that one coin, as you've seen there. Wait, actually, for 2 coins in this level, come to think of it. So, let's just grab the Yoshi, because it's kind of a necessity. You know, they are quite the ride, I have to say. They're pretty expensive, though. Whoa, shoot! No! Come back here! And whenever you get a hit, or take a hit with Yoshi, he runs off. He's a very cowardly dinosaur, I must say. He could just wait for you to jump back on him, but he doesn't. He just runs off. It's kind of disappointing, actually. It might be because he's disoriented from being drugged up. As you know the story from Yoshi, or maybe you don't know the story from Yoshi, he's been a drug addict ever since Yoshi's Island with those fuzzy spores, and I have just been having a hard time getting him off those fuzzies, and so anyway, over here is a little secret. Yeah, it's kind of a cheap secret, I have to say, but it's a secret nonetheless. There's a coin up there. I guess you need Yoshi for this one. Wait, do you need Yoshi for this one? You might. Yeah, I think you do need Yoshi for that one. So I guess you need Yoshi for all 3 coins. Well, at least to make them easier. Here's another berry. I might as well keep eating the berries for the heck of it. Oh! Up here. If you go up past the ceiling here with Yoshi, yeah, you do need Yoshi. There's a bunch of coins, and the secret exit is down that way. I'll be back there a little bit later, but for now I'm just gonna get the normal exit, which can be gotten by just following the normal path here. And I just noticed you can't get fire from just slurping up piranha plants, but if they're throwing fire at you as you're slurping them up, you'll get a fireball. Or at least that's what I think, because that happened to me one time, and it didn't work like that for me. I don't know why. But anyway, you can't keep Yoshi outside the level you find them in, which is too bad. But I suppose he could break some levels with that flutter jump thing, so that's probably why they don't let you keep him, and that's probably why they don't have a cape, or they don't have any more, like, flying items like capes, such as the original Super Mario Brothers, and there's a toad, by the way. This letter, yeah, every annoying toad they find, they're going to carry, they're going to hide inside a block, excuse me. So, what the heck, Goomba? Defend yourself! No! I'll explain the toad mechanic later, but for now, I'm just gonna go and get the secret exit of this level. So, here we go, 1-3 again. This will take you to a warp cannon, which will take you to a later level in the game, which I'm not gonna show you until I get there. So, it's kind of pointless to even show this secret exit, but at the same time, for 100%, you need to find this exit anyway. So, I might as well clear out the level as I go. I should say, the world as I go, anyway. What am I collecting this used star coins for, anyway? I don't know. So, let's just go and run through the level as fast as I can for the fun of it, because I really don't have anything else to collect. Though, I should be careful to keep my ride here, because I do need him for the secret exit, as I showed you before. Oh, it's right up here. Well, that was quick. Come on, Yoshi. There you go. Woo! Happy days! Collect your pocket change. Hello there, and inside magical pipe that you can't see up there. And there'll be a little Yoshi jump segment here where you need a little flutter jump to get across. Oops! I let go of the button too early. Arrgh! Silly me. And there we go! Got a 1-up. Red flags indicate secret exits, black flags, normal exits. Remember that. And that will unlock the path to the canon, as I said before, which I'm not going to delve into. I think what I'm going to do is show off the toad mechanic, because I'm not really going to be doing this much through the game. It's kind of annoying to do, except when you're in low numbered levels, like early game levels, because this is kind of tricky to do. Listen for, or I should say, go into a level that you'll see a crying toad, and then listen for his cries. Listen. Hear that? In this block is likely a toad. Yay! You can pick him up, and the object is to take him to the end of the stage. And if you do take him successfully to the end of the stage, you'll get a reward. And he's completely oblivious on his own. Look at this, he runs around in a panic. Why can't he make it to the end of the stage on his own? You know Toad is powerful enough to do that. Especially when you can play as him in multiplayer. But anyway, yeah, just carry him along by picking him up by shaking the Wii remote, and that's really all there is to it. It's interesting to note that when you have a Toad in your possession, you can't fly when you have the propeller mushroom power-up. Just saying, that also makes things a little more difficult. If he ever takes a hit, well, I'll just let him take a hit here. Come on, take a hit. There we go. If he ever takes a hit, he'll shrink just like Mario does. He's a little cute toad! And if he takes two hits, he dies and you can't get the prize from him. But take him all the way to the goal and you'll get that prize.
Oh, yeah!
Gotta love Toad's voice. And I guess if you keep him, if he's at maximum size, excuse me, he'll give you 3 1-ups. If he's small, he'll give you 1 1-up. And then by saving that Toad or bringing him to the end of the stage, it doesn't matter which level that ends up on. You'll unlock a house on that arrow panel, or I should say arrow space on the board. And it'll be for some sort of random toad house. This is for a cannon minigame to collect lives. You just jump into a cannon and go down into it like a pipe. Angle yourself by tilting the Wii remote, and then fire when you're ready with the jump button. Depending on how many balloons you hit, differs, you know, with the number. I mean, excuse me. Dang it, why can't I explain things today? Depending on the total of the numbers on the balloons that you hit, you'll get that many 1-ups. Like I said, this game gives away 1-ups like candy. Star mushroom houses like this will give you a star power-up. So let's just go into the house. It'll always give you a star power-up no matter what, so there's no reason not to go into these houses right away to get their power-ups. Stars are really only good to use when there's not an auto-scroll level or something like that. Just a pro tip for you. When you press the 1 button on the map, you can use the items that you've collected just by selecting them and pressing the 2 button to use them. And that's really about it for the items. Let's go to the castle! Woo! I believe that's Iggy, if I'm not mistaken. I don't really know the Koopa Kids by heart, and some Super Mario fan is gonna be slapping me. I've been hoping that I'll get the Koopa Kids back into the games, and you don't even know their names. Well, I did kind of miss the Koopa Kids for a while myself, but I've never been good with names, honestly. I don't know why, I've just never been good at memorizing names. So I'm just gonna say he's Iggy. I think he's Iggy, so I'm gonna go with Iggy. that Iggy was the first boss of the original Super Mario World. As you can see, you can go up there to get a star coin. That's the first one level, by the way. You can either wall kick up there, jump onto that chocolate-like block there, or just use your propeller mushroom if you've got one. The second coin is right up here. This path is even easier than the normal path, when you just wall kick up there or fly up there. And the third coin is nearing the top, so let's just careful not to get squished by these choco blocks, and wait, I should be jumping up here, not wall kicking, there's a little edge there. Whenever you see a block like this, if you hit it at the right time, well, I shouldn't say the right time, you gotta time your hit to collect whatever item is showing. Like, I'm gonna aim for a propeller mushroom for the fun of it. So, there we go. Just like that, and I got a propeller mushroom. Over here, if you fly up and hit this blank space, you'll get a mushroom like that. Well, it's a one-up mushroom, excuse me. And going all the way up here will get you a coin. You can either wall kick or fly up there. Flying up there is much... Whoa! Nearly an ambush. Flying up there is much easier. Red coin challenge! Not very hard. These get a lot harder as the game progresses naturally, so take advantage of getting the 1-ups while you can, even though lives don't really matter all that much in this game. Except when you hit like a checkpoint or something and you don't want to continue from the very beginning. But you get so many lives, that's rarely a factor. In fact, I had to forcefully see the game over screen. I'd never seen it on my first run through this game. Anyway, go through this door, and the first castle boss is here, and I'm gonna say again, it's probably Iggy. At least I think it's Iggy. Just jump on his head, he'll take damage. He's got this attack where he slides across the floor after you hit him. And he's also got a magic attack where he uses that wand to throw or shoot magic blasts at you. Come on, do it, there we go. That's not hard to dodge at all, as you can see there. And he can jump, that's really all there is to it. He's very basic, very beginner, very easy to beat, but he should be. It's the first boss of the game. You can also die down those holes, also. But if you got any platforming experience, I would not expect you to fall down there accidentally. And he's gonna run away like a coward, go to the next castle. I guess that was like a fortress. That's a fortress, and this is a castle coming up. Like that. And let's just go to the next level and clear out the coins of it as well. Yay! And one... What? Yeah, I'll save, thank you. What? And here we go! 1-4! Let's get this started. This will probably be the last level that'll do in this part, so let's make the most of it. Gotta love the music in this game. I always say that about a lot of games' music. But you know, music really gets you into it. I mean, if you have bad music, it just kind of ruins the feel of it. In case you don't realize, this is going to be an underwater level. The fish dance with the music like all the enemies. I forgot to mention that. Whenever there's like a ah or a ring or sound or something like that in the music, the enemies dance to it. It's kind of entertaining. Listen and watch. Cute! That can also actually throw you off a little bit, because they get up and jump up one square higher than they were before, so that can throw you off your jump timing if you aren't paying attention to the music. But it doesn't happen too often. For this stage, you're gonna need the ice flower, and try to keep it as much as you can, so you can get a bunch of the star coins here. So, be very careful not to lose it. Oh, look at the little cheep cheeps! They're so cute! I'm starting to sound like Toad, dang it. As you can see, there's a current coming out of those pipes. The current will naturally push you, and sometimes will push you into the fish. And this is a lot of fish. A lot of fish! Look at all of them! You can either freeze them, get past them, which is kind of a waste of time, or just swim around them, which is what I'm doing there. But I'm freezing them just for the fun of it. You can also freeze these urchins, which you can use the ice as platforms, or use them to get to other coins. No. There we go. If that fish would have popped, so to speak, would have broke up by the time I got over it, I wouldn't have been able to get that star coin, because that current would have kept me away from it. Dang it! I wanted to try to jump over it outside the water. Well, at least I got another ice power-up. For this one here, you want to freeze a fish right when it gets in the middle, like that, and then ride it all the way up to the top. This is the easiest way to get the star coin. I think you can just keep pressing the jump button to push yourself up there, or swim yourself up there. This next one over here is pretty interesting. Get this urchin to be frozen right above that pipe, and when it breaks, it's gonna die, but it's gonna plug up this pipe, and it's gonna let you go through to get the star coin. And down here is a little secret as well. So let's see what's inside. Let's see what delicious secrets await us. In case you don't realize, these clams, if they close on you, you're gonna take damage. Oh my god, if I forgot these fish home in on you! Must get star! Must get more! I could just freeze the fish. That works for me too. Ow! Oh, I guess I can't freeze the fish for long. Dang it. I can kill him with a fire flower. I don't need my ice power up anyway. Because I got all the star coins at this level. Yay, I got another one up. Now, just look at this. I'm already at 21 lives. And I've only been through 4 stages of the game. There's a balance issue here with the live system. But then again, I'm not complaining. It would be kind of annoying to keep having to go back through the game over screen and stuff like that. Spiky fish, you must die! Die and feel pain for hitting me earlier. Well, those two aren't the culprits. I shouldn't blame their brothers. Jump on this Koopa. I was gonna say jump on this Koopa to get to the goal there, to the top of the goal. But you don't necessarily need them. Just jump and spin to get to the top. And that about does it. I hope you enjoyed this part, and I'll see you guys in the next part.